I mean, full length uh-huh. Adidas film coming out with all the young guys.
Yeah.
And me, the young guy.
Just random little things that stick out in my mind from Mark. He's someone who has done away with all personal inhibitions and is kind of just living out every thought that comes into his mind.
Hi, I'm from KPSW News Radio. I really like your move.
I met Gon's father when I got on Real in 2000. Yeah, he's great. He just has an awesome approach to skating. It's like infectious. He's just having fun. It makes everybody want to have fun. And he basically doesn't give a fuck in like a real kind of way, not in a contrived way.
I mean, Mark's always been and still is super inspirational. Just watching him push down the street and like how much fun he has skating, and it's inspiring to be around that kind of energy.
I'm nervous. Yeah, but I'm just even scared to do that.
He's always slammed though. Like even when he was young, I don't think he's really had injuries. On video days, he slammed to his knees from jumping down Wallenberg and everything, and he's always taken some crazy hits. Today, I guess he broke his rib trying to get over that barrier, but that might have been his first broken bone. He gets out of it, though. As I also believe he's made out of rubber. I don't know what's up with his iPod filming. It goes hand in hand with his laptop filming, which is even more interesting. I don't know. He just wants to film and he just uses whatever equipment he has around.
We're doing it.
There's so many gnarly, fucking so many gnarly Mark Gonzales tricks. But off the top of my head, on that square flat bar in the underground that they used to skate, the frontside 180 to switch feeble grind and then pop it back out to forward on the same side in video days, and then the fucking caveman dark slide on the rail.
That crazy hippie jump he did at the end of that, his real part, where he ollied, there was a bar, it was two, and then he ollied this one and then kicked it and then landed and kind of lands with one leg and does it. Insane. He was always doing his own thing. He didn't care where he went, what he did, and that's what separated him with his personality, with how he looked at skateboarding, how he was around people too, and trying to, he was always like amped and trying to amp people up around him. And I mean, I just think about some of his parts too, like the spots that he hit. He was one of those guys who was like, oh, nobody wants to touch that. I'll be the first one to touch it. I think that's what makes him like so different from everybody else. And that's what makes him so great. And that's why he is the Gonz.
Maybe Mark understands the impact of what he was just naturally doing back then, but fuck, dude, I don't know if you do understand like how many people's lives that you shaped and the influence you had on so many people who are now like sitting here, like right now, like, but you definitely had like the most amazing impact on the way that I look at skateboarding and the way that I, you know, sometimes choose to do things or whatever. And I just want to say thank you for that. And, I want to say happy birthday, and like, we all love you. Thank you so much.